Hello everyone. Today I am going to explain direct and inverse proportion with the help of real life examples. So before starting the topic, let us recall what is ratio. What is ratio? When we compare two or more quantities of the same kind and in the same unit, it is called ratio. Now what do we mean by same kind?
If we take ratio of cost of a book and cost of a pen, we are not comparing the book and the pen. We are comparing cost in rupees of both. Now, same unit means if we compare height of a pole with height of a man and we take height of a pole in meter, then we must take height of a man also in meter. We can't take one in meter and other in centimeter.
Now what is proportion? When we compare two ratios and if they are equal, we say that they are in proportion. We take an example of a cake.
Suppose one day mother gives you one cake and she gives me two cake. I get double than you or you are getting half than me. Next day she gives you two cakes and me four cakes. Again I get double than you. Then we say that both the ratios 1 by 2 and 2 by 4 are in proportion. Let us take a different example. Suppose one day she gives you one cake and me two cakes. But next day she gives you two cakes and me three cakes. Then ratios are 1 by 2 and 2 by 3. They are not in proportion as they are not equivalent.
Let us discuss the two types of proportion with the help of some more examples. More the number of caps, more the cost.
Oh Dad, I enjoy long drive very much.
Oh dear, more the distance, more the consumption of petrol.
When one quantity, that is number of caps, increases or decreases, the other quantity, that is cost, also increases or decreases. Think and answer. What are the two quantities in situation 2? Second, how do these quantities increase or decrease? Second proportion is indirect proportion.
I have to complete in 8 hours. Lot of work. I'm tired.
Together we can finish the work in 4 hours.
What do we see? When one quantity, that is number of persons, increase or decrease, the other quantities, that is number of days food will last, will decrease or increase. Name the two quantities in situation 2.